y'all have submitted so many stories that it's stressing me out. Keep them coming, okay? Y'all know y'all doing something right when I can't even read my own comment section at night. I'm scared, low-key. Part 3 of Spiritual Reparations. Jay Artistic. I had a black homegirl who was a CNA, and her patient complained about these dreams she was having. One night she woke up screaming and kept saying, "I'm sorry," over and over. "I'm sorry for what happened to your people." Whittington Mika 129. Years ago when I was a CNA, this man was dying and he was hugging his legs with one hand and waving the other hand around the bed, yelling, "Get these flames away from me. It's burning. It's burning." Well, what you do, John? Okay. Brandy Chaplin. I'll never forget working at this place and the back hall was haunted. This couple would constantly call me into their room and tell me to tell those 3 black kids in the corner to get out of my room. Looked over there and walked out because I'm not going to miss out on this torture you probably done to them. Oh, Lord. Y'all going to have me going to hell with gasoline draws on, okay? Because this shit is comical. When I tell you the hair on my arms used to stand up when her husband started saying it, I quit. Sis said, get somebody else to do it. Dr. Coco. I was working at a nursing home in North Carolina for 4 years as the chef. One night I was clocking out. I heard one of the residents weeping in the dining room. As I get closer to see about her, she started saying, "Precious Lord, help me." Then the room just got ice cold. Something told me to walk away, and I did. Next day, the director asked me if I saw anyone come in after my shift. The resident that was in the dining room had scratches and bruises from what she says was a field slave's doing. Ain't no field slaves here. Off to memory care. Y'all, I am dead. This person submitted a story already. I worked as a CNA / caregiver. This woman was on the other side of the same floor from the lady who had the dark figure in her room. This lady would press her button and run out of there. We had just checked her room in twos. She didn't have dementia or Alzheimer's, which made it scarier. 3 boys in red were tormenting her at night, so she couldn't sleep. She would scream. She would say, "They're behind us." At first, I would press. I gotta find the rest of this story, y'all, because it's not here, okay? But I'd be scared. Nichelle Cartel. So we go to the basement, and in about 8 boxes, nothing but KKK items. But my client always told me sorry, and we ran out of time. But like for part 4, because it's going up on a Tuesday.